Hi, welcome to this training video on eFuse protection solutions for 24 volts as well as 48 volt supply rail systems. In this training video, we will discuss about protection requirements and solutions for industrial applications. So, what are the typical end equipments that run on 24 volts as well as 48 volts power rail? This slide shows several end equipments in industrial, automotive, and enterprise and comms where the protection is needed. In industrial space, equipments like PLC that run on 24 volt supplies need protection from various faults. In automotive space, protection is needed in applications that are powered directly from a 12 volt battery. In enterprise and comms, protection on several voltage domains like 24 volts, 32 volts, and 42 volts is needed. The common protection requirements are hot plug and inrush current control, short circuit protection, reverse current protection or reverse current blocking, overvoltage protection, and reverse polarity protection. So let us discuss about specific protection requirements for industrial applications. Apart from the protection needs that we discussed in the previous slide, the industrial equipments, for example, the PLC and the transmitter systems, need to comply with EMC immunity standards. Most commonly applied EMC tests are the system ESD, the electrical fast transient, and the surge test. Out of these three tests, surge test has the highest energy content that can destroy the end equipments if appropriate protection circuits are not used. As shown in this figure, the duration of the surge test pulse is longer than the ESD as well as the EFT pulse. The energy in the surge pulse is approximately 100 times higher than in a typical EFT pulse train. So let us discuss a few system examples. This slide shows the power tree of a PLC CPU module, which is powered from an external field power supply. A PLC CPU module is a processing unit in a PLC system. The protection needs in this end equipment are input reverse polarity protection in case of field supply miswiring, inrush current limiting, as this equipment can have higher amount of input capacitance for the holdup requirements, overvoltage and undervoltage protection during the external power supply faults, reverse current blocking during the power fail test in accordance to the IEC 61131-2 test, the load protection during the surge test, which is conducted on the input 24 volt supply line. In a PLC analog input module, protection is needed on the input supply side as well as other ports like sensor power supply and the analog signal input port. On the input port, the protection needs are reverse polarity protection due to the field supply miswiring, overvoltage and undervoltage protection due to the external power supply faults, and load protection during the surge test, which is conducted on the 24 volts field supply line. On the output port, the protection requirements are reverse current blocking due to the field miswiring, the output short circuit protection, surge immunity on the 24 volt supply line, and the reverse polarity protection since this port can have a screw type of connector. Apart from the power ports, protection is also needed on the signal ports as shown here. So let us now discuss about various circuit implementation for protection. This slide shows a discrete based protection solution that has a fuse for short circuit and the overload current limiting. It has a TVS clamp for the surge protection. It has a diode for reverse polarity protection as well as a reverse current blocking. There are also LC circuits to slow down the input voltage slew rate during the surge test. And it has a P-channel FET with associated RC circuit for the inrush current limiting, as well as the zener references, the signal resistors and the comparators to cut off the power path during the overvoltage as well as undervoltage events. This solution is bulky and an inefficient solution. Imagine there is a 2 ampere of load current flowing through this path, and this can result in 1 watt of power dissipation on the diode itself, and it can increase the board temperature. The LC based solution adds board size and it can be a bulky solution. The p-channel FET is again a bigger FET and it has a higher component count. The fuses are typically very slow in response, and this can take in an order of milliseconds to seconds to respond during the short circuit faults. And during this slow response, the load can damage before the fuse opens up. The fuse has a very wide current limit inaccuracy of plus minus 50% across the temperature range. And this circuit does not have the thermal shutdown feature. Here we show a semi-discrete solution that is based out of a hot swap and an O-ring controller based solution with an external FETs and a current sense resistor. Following are the protection features with this design. The inrush current control, overvoltage protection, undervoltage protection, the output short circuit protection, overload current limit, reverse polarity protection, and the reverse current blocking. While designing these circuits, a careful selection of the FETs is needed. This slide shows an eFuse based protection scheme. As shown here, the eFuse has integrated FETs with all the protection features which we discussed on the previous slide. The eFuse is a compact solution that offers complete integrated robust protection, and it is easy to use. One of such eFuses is the TPS2660. This eFuse has integrated 60 volt back-to-back FETs with a fully integrated reverse polarity protection. This eFuse operates from a 4.2 volts to 55 volts supply. This device features programmable output slew rate control, a very high current limit accuracy of plus minus 5%, back-to-back 60 volt power FETs along with a proprietary control algorithm for surge protection simplifies the system design for surge compliance. Using the mode pin of this device, the system designers can configure the overload fault behavior either in latch, auto retry, or circuit breaker mode. The device also features programmable overvoltage protection and undervoltage protection. Apart from the protection features, the device also features analog current monitor as well as the fault pin, which can be useful for load diagnostics. This device comes in a leaded as well as a QFN package. Key performance graphs of the TPS2660. Here we show the input hot plug response using an external cap. One can program the output voltage slew rate and control the inrush current. Here we demonstrate the input reverse polarity protection, and the output is protected from the input negative voltages due to the back-to-back FET architecture. This is the output hotshot response. The device turns off the FETs within 200 nanoseconds, isolating the input supply from the output short circuit faults. This is the response of the TPS2660 during the input voltage interruption test. The device has got a very fast reverse current blocking feature, which ensures no voltage droop on the output. This slide shows the surge performance of the TPS2660 along with an external TVS clamp. The left-hand side scope shot shows the positive 500 volt surge performance, and the right-hand side scope shot shows the negative 500 volt surge performance. The load as well as the device gets protected from the overvoltages as well as the negative voltages during the surge test. Due to the harsh environment and exposure to threats like EST, EFT, and the lightning surges, industrial system is always susceptible to catastrophic failure. Robust power circuit protection is needed in such industrial applications. The TPS2660, industry's first 60 volts back-to-back FET integrated, easy-to-use eFuse offers robust power path protection for industrial applications. For more details and design support on the TPS2660, please visit the product homepage at the website link shown here. Thanks for watching the video.